Myself, Prashant Vishwanath Dhanshetti, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am here to explain you about slope and deflection of cantilever beam with gradually varying load by double integration method. So today's learning outcome is, at the end of this session, student will be able to understand and find the slope and deflection of cantilever beam with uniformly varying load for the following condition: when uniformly varying load is acting over whole span and when it is acting for a distance a from the fixed end. So before that, we will see what is the beam. A beam is a structural element that primarily resists loads applied lateral to the beam axis, and the mode of deflection is by bending. So this is the beam, and it is resisting the load perpendicular or lateral to it, and there is the deflection of the beam or bending of the beam. So the beams are classified according to support conditions: cantilever beam, simply supported beam, overhanging beam, fixed beam, and continuous beam. So we are dealing with the cantilever beam. So before that, again we have to see what is slope and deflection, to find the slope and deflection of the cantilever. So every beam is frequently governed by rigidity rather than its strength. Hence, the building code specifies the limit of deflection, because excessive deflection of the beam not only is visually disturbing but may also cause damage to other parts of the building. So therefore, many building codes limits the maximum deflection of the beam. So we have to know what is the deflection of the beam when the load is applied. So deflection of the beam at any point on the axis of the beam is the distance between its position before and after loading. So initially the load beam is straight before loading. When load is applied, it gets deflected. So distance between initial and final after loading, so this distance is called a deflection. Slope of the beam at any section in a deflected beam is defined as the angle in radians which the tangent at the section makes with original axis of the beam. So now this is the deflected shape of the beam. So here I have drawn a tangent line to this deflected shape, and again a horizontal line which is the shows initial position of the beam. So this angle theta is the slope of the beam. So cantilever beam is the beam which is fixed at one end and free at the other end. So one end is fixed whereas the other end is free. There are various methods of finding slope and deflection for cantilevers which are mentioned below, that is double integration method, Macaulay's method, moment area method. So we will see the double integration method. So the equations used for double integration method, how it has arisen. So when a beam is deflected in a curvature, so it will have some center or origin, that is O, and it will have some radius R. So the radius of curvature of the deflected beam is given by the flexure formula, that is M upon I is equals to E by R. Therefore M upon EI is equals to 1 upon R. So we will treat this as equation A. So for a practical beam, 1 upon R is given by D2Y by DX square, equation B. So now equating this equation A and B, we get M upon EI is equals to D2Y by DX square. Therefore M is equals to EI D2Y by DX square, with this is the equation 1 which we are going to use for double integration method. So now we will consider a beam which is fixed at one end at A and it is free at the other end, and the load is uniformly varying. So it is having intensity 0 at point B, that is at free end, and it is having the maximum load, that is W per unit length at point A. So due to this load, there is again a deflection A B dash. It shows the deflected shape of the beam. So your YB is the deflection and theta B is the slope which we have to find. So now we will consider a section at a distance X from the fixed end. So remaining portion will be L minus X. So now we have to take a bending moment at this section X from the free end. So the load is this triangular part, and the value here at the section of this triangle is WL into L minus X. So for taking this triangular moment, So we have to take the load into distance from which it is acting. So now this mx is equals 2. So now as this is a triangle, it is 1/2 base into height. So it is minus 1/2. So L minus x is the base into W by L into L minus x. This is this ordinate. And it is acting at 1/3 L minus x. So after solving this, we get mx is equals to minus W upon 6L into bracket L minus x cube. This is equation 2. So now we know the bending moment, and we know from equation A, moment is equals to EI d2y by dx square. So putting here the moment, so we get EI d2y by dx square is equals to minus W upon 6L into bracket L minus x cube. So now integrating this above equation, we get EI dy by dx is equals to minus W upon 6L into bracket L minus x raised to 4 upon 4 into minus 1 plus C1, where C1 is the constant of integration. So we will treat this as equation number 3. So again, integrating this equation number 3, we get EI y is equals to W upon 24 into L minus x raised to 5 by 5 into minus 1 plus C1x plus C2, where C2 is again a constant of integration. So solving, we get this equation EI y is equals to minus W upon 120 L into bracket L minus x raised to 5 plus C1x plus C2. So we have to find out the constant of integration C1 and C2 from the boundary condition of the beam. So now, what are the boundary condition for the cantilever? So here, pause the video and try to get answer. So as the support end is fixed, the values obtained for the boundary condition are: at x is equals to 0, deflection y is 0, and at x is equals to 0, slope dy by dx is also 0. Now substituting this value in equation number 4, we get 0 is equals to minus W upon 120 L into L minus, now we are replacing x by 0 raised to 5 plus C1 into x, it is 0 plus C2. So solving this, we get C2 is equals to WL4 by 120. Again, putting the value of x is equals to 0 and slope dy by dx is equals to 0 in equation number 3, we get 0 is equals to W upon 24L into bracket L minus 0 raised to 4 plus C1. So from this we get C1 is equals to minus WL cube by 24. Now substituting the value of C1 minus WL cube by 24 in equation 3, we get EI dy by dx is equals to W by 24L into bracket L minus x raised to 4 minus WL cube upon 24. This is equation number 5, which is known as slope equation. We can find out now slope at any point on a cantilever beam by substituting the value of x, and let the slope is maximum at free end, it will be theta b. So putting x is equals to L and dy by dx is equals to theta b, we get EI theta b is equals to W by 24L into bracket L minus L raised to 4 minus WL cube by 24. So L minus L will be 0. So we are getting EI theta b is equals to minus WL cube by 24. Therefore, theta b is equals to minus WL cube by 24 EI. That is equation 5a. So negative sign shows it is an anticlockwise direction. Now again, substituting the value of C1 is equals to minus WL cube by 24 and C2 is equals to WL4 by 120 in equation 4, we get EIY is equals to minus W by 120L into bracket L minus X raised to 5 minus WL cube upon 24 into X plus WL4 upon 120. This is equation number 6, which is known as deflection equation. So we can find out deflection at any point on the cantilever by substituting the value of x in this above equation. So the deflection is maximum at free end. So let the deflection be yb and x is equals to L. So putting this in equation 6, we get EI yb is equals to minus W upon 120 L into bracket L minus L raised to 5 minus WL cube by 24 into L plus WL4 by 120. So solving this, we get minus WL4 by 30. Therefore, YB is equals to minus WL4 by 30 EI. That is equation number 6A. So this negative sign shows the deflection is downward. Now slope and deflection of uniformly varying load at a distance A from the fixed end. So we will consider this from a fixed end, that distance A, the load is acting over this triangular portion. So now theta C is the slope at this point C, and YC is the deflection at point C, and YB is the deflection at point B. So now as the load is acting over this portion in between A and C, so the deflection of the beam is between A and C, and the rest it remains straight. So now using the same equation which we have derived in equation 5A and 6A, instead of L we have to put the value of A, because we are neglecting this, means as there is no bending moment in this portion. So deflection is like this, therefore theta C is equals to WA4 by 24 EI and YC is equals to WA4 by 30 EI. So now for finding the deflection at point B, so as this is a straight line, so theta C is equals to theta B, that is WA4 by 24 EI. But for YB, we have to add YC plus theta C into bracket L minus A, because this is theta C and we have to solve this by triangular method. So YB is equals to WA4 upon 30 EI plus WA4 upon 24 EI into bracket L minus A. So we have replaced this theta C with WA4 upon 24 EI. So these are the references which I have referred. Thank you.